Welcome, and thank you for watching the first episode of our Top Trends in Energy video series. These videos are a series of discussions with industry experts that aim to shed light on current trends shaping the future of the energy sector. I'm Hanna Grene, Worldwide Power and Utilities Leader at Microsoft. We're talking today about power and utilities within the energy industry broader sector. And we're going to be talking about opportunities for investment and modernization of the US electric grid. We're excited to speak with Dr. Karen Wayland. Karen is the CEO of the GridWise Alliance and a recognized expert in national energy and environmental policy, who served as a leader at the US Department of Energy during the Obama administration. Through her business, KW, as in Kilowatt Energy Strategies, she provides strategic consulting on grid modernization policy, coalition building, and communications for major clean energy companies and national environmental organizations. Thank you so much for being with us today, Karen. It's just wonderful to have you and to be in this discussion with you.
It's a pleasure to speak with you, Hanna.
To get our discussion started, Karen, can you first tell us about what GridWise Alliance does and how you're working with the industry to improve grid resilience and implement more smart grid technology?
So GridWise Alliance is a membership organization of utilities, of technology companies like Microsoft, grid equipment manufacturers. We have three of the five regional transmission organizations as members, consulting firms who work with utilities and other players in the grid space. And we were founded in 2003 in very close conjunction with the U.S. Department of Energy as they began their smart grid initiative. We helped develop the definition of smart grid that Congress eventually adopted, and we worked on funding for the smart grid program for in the 2009 Recovery Act. And we've been working as a voice to articulate the benefits of grid modernization since our founding. And we work very closely again with Congress on the infrastructure bill that I know we're going to talk about, which is really historic and I think is going to be a game changer for the industry.
Thanks, Karen. It has just been a joy to watch GridWise come in and really drive this conversation around smart grid and put together the different pieces of technology, policy, consumer awareness that it really takes to drive this giant transformation forward. And I'd love to know, you know, when you speak with utility executives, what do you hear about how they're navigating these waters? And really, where do you see us going as an industry in the face of these challenges and opportunities?
Well, it is a very exciting time for the utility sector, exciting and scary. The technologies that are available are changing really quickly. The demands, as you mentioned, that we're asking of the grid and of the people working in the industry are changing very rapidly. You mentioned security, dealing with climate change, resilience, making sure that the most vulnerable among us aren't overburdened by inaffordable, you know, the energy burden. So it is a challenge for utility executives, but there are also some real opportunities. When you talk about one of the biggest solutions for the climate challenge is beneficial electrification. Part of it is resources. Part of it is sometimes being stuck in an old way of thinking, but it is happening, you know, in some places very rapidly and in other places. And I think where it's not happening fast, it isn't because utilities don't want to see these happening. They don't want to burden their customers. They can't burden their customers with the costs of grid modernization. So when you talk about equity, there are absolute economic benefits. There are benefits, human costs and benefits to a modern grid. For example, a modern grid will respond more quickly to disturbances. So you get your power back on. You can monitor your energy use and you can reduce your energy use when you don't need it so that you can manage your electricity bill. There are real benefits to the customer and benefits to society at large with a modern grid. And if we have some places of the country that can't make those investments for whatever reason, we are going to be in a situation where the benefits of that modern grid are unequally delivered around the country.
Absolutely. Could not agree more. So with the technologies that we have and the goals that we have, the uniqueness of the moment we're in today is we have investment dollars. And I'm wondering if you can share with us a little bit with the investment that we have from the Infrastructure Investment and Jobs Act, or IIJA of 2021, and then this year's Inflation Reduction Act, or IRA. Where do you see these making, you know, a real impact in the sector? And how is GridWise engaging to help, you know, steer or advise on how that those investments are being made.
Well, we started thinking about what might be in some sort of economic stimulus package way back, you know, just a few months after COVID hit. And so we started developing a set of recommendations that we called Grid Investments for Economic Recovery to kind of lay out a $50 billion agenda for Congress to really, you know, if they were going to put money into some sort of economic recovery package, because we'd been talking about an infrastructure bill for years and it never happened. So then all of a sudden we got the opportunity to take our recommendations and try to influence the infrastructure bill. And I think we were successful beyond our wildest dreams, because when you add up all the money that's available just for the grid, we're not talking about buildings, we're not talking about electric vehicles, we're not talking about you know, energy efficiency or renewable generation, just the grid, there's somewhere on the order of $70 billion that utilities are eligible for in some way to make improvements to the grid. There's a lot of money coming into the electricity space that is going to really, I think, transform the way the system works.
When I think about, you know, where we go beyond the immediate needs for investment in the grid, because we do have baseline needs to upgrade what in some parts of the country is a 100-year-old aged system. But when I think beyond those just core baseline upgrades, you know, where do you see the big transformative leap ahead investments that we can make that support utilities and our customers? And what are the top priorities for GridWise as you look further out into the future?
That's a great question, because we looked back at the Recovery Act and we looked at what were the technologies that law and that federal funding really drove for deployment. And it was a lot of advanced meters and it was single phasers. So really giving you visibility into how the system and what the customers are doing. Back in 2009, when the Recovery Act passed, I found a DOE report that predicted that we'd be at 100% deployment of advanced meters by 2020. Well, we are not at 100%. So if you look at Nevada, my former hometown, Washington, where I live now, something like 97% of the customers in both those places are attached to the grid through an advanced meter. But in New England, it's like 22%. So it's not, and you would think even in states where they have climate policy, they have very forward-looking push around the electricity sector, but they still don't have 100% advanced meters. And so we have to make sure that when we're looking forward to the really interesting technologies that allow us to do a lot of fun things, that we don't leave any communities behind with the basic infrastructure of the modern grid. So what I do find most exciting that I think is really a game changer is this convergence of the electricity sector with transportation and the convergence of the electricity sector with communications. And both of those things will allow us to manage the grid differently and to really take advantage of distributed energy resources, the storage that's in vehicles, and allow fast movement of data across the system through this advanced communication network.
That is such a great reflection, Karen. I wanted to just, you know, touch on one more piece, which is around big data. You know, one of the challenges that we see utilities facing is moving from on-premise IT systems to more of a cloud and hybrid infrastructure. And I think there's a key technology piece of that where Microsoft's leaning in and we're supporting utilities to think about a connected data estate and connected data-driven operations, both in how they run their business and in how they run the operational technology or OT parts of the grid. There's a human element too, which is that utilities have often operated in silos, right? There's a transmission group and a customer programs group, maybe an asset operations group, and then, you know, broader, maybe more back-end functions who buy things separately. And we see the huge opportunity, as you say, the broader convergence in the industry. There's a data convergence too, and bringing more cloud computing and data capabilities across the full life cycle of a utility. And so I'd love your thoughts on that too, and how you might be seeing that at GridWise.
Well, data is going to be critical for figuring out how to operate the grid differently based on all the things that we are asking it to do. And we are seeing, you know, the growing digitization or digitalization of the grid. So as equipment is added to the grid, it it is generating more and more data. And so part of the critical component of a modern grid are those cloud storage and data analytics that the utility needs in order to turn that data into information. So figuring out how we harmonize investments in the hardware with the actually critical and essential partner, which is the software, is going to be something very important to accelerate this transition to a modern grid.
Thank you. I could not agree more. And I think of it as even just a conceptual shift from IT and OT to digital infrastructure, right? That crosses both of those lanes. And that's definitely the direction that we're all headed in smart grid. Thank you so much, Karen, for sharing your perspective in this insightful discussion. If you're interested in hearing more perspectives on the present and future of the energy sector, watch the rest of our Top Trends in Energy video series, which features other industry experts discussing the latest trends they're seeing at the intersection of technology and energy. Thanks so much. Mm-hmm.